Blackstone presents G.I. Joe Classified by Kelley Skovron. This book is read by Shawn Compton. Chapter 1. A Real American Town. Stan and his mother drove into the town of Springfield late on a Sunday afternoon. He was watching a video on his phone, so he hadn't noticed, but his mother tapped him on the shoulder. Stan paused his video. Huh? She pointed to a huge LED sign by the side of the road that said, "Welcome to Springfield, a real American town." She grinned as they drove past.
"You see, Stanisław?"
she asked in her thick Polish accent.
"A real American town."
"Isn't Chicago a real American town?" he asked sourly. She waved her hand dismissively.
"Chicago is Chicago."
Stan couldn't argue with that. Chicago was special. Unique. He missed it already. He eyed Springfield's wide streets and orderly buildings suspiciously. Everything was new and streamlined here, with digital billboards and luminous street signs. It was smooth and sleek, like out of some sci-fi movie. He had to admit that it looked neat, but it wasn't Chicago.
"This is a great opportunity for us, Stanisław," his mother said. "DeCobray is one of the most successful companies in the world. My promotion is going to help both of us in many ways."
"I know, Mom," because this was probably about the 20th time she'd told him.
"I'll be making more money now, too, so we will be able to afford nice things."
"Can't wait." He would have preferred keeping his friends to having nice things.
"And Springfield has one of the best-rated school systems in the country. You will be able to go to any college you want."
"Great." He knew he was supposed to be excited about that, but it seemed so far away. A million years from now. Her brow furrowed.
"That is, if you work hard."
"I will, Mom," Stan said with a hint of irritation. He always tried hard in school.
"And no fights."
Stan winced. "And no fights." He wasn't a violent boy. He didn't enjoy fighting. But when he saw someone get bullied, it made his blood boil. What was he supposed to do? Let people get beat up? Her expression softened.
"You miss your friends back in Chicago."
"I miss everything back in Chicago, Mom. Just look at this place." Stan gestured to a restaurant they were driving past called Red Rocket, which seemed to have an actual functional rocket on top. There were no brick townhomes, no winding streets, no deep dish pizza places. This far from Illinois, they probably hadn't even heard of Portillo's. She frowned.
"It is a very nice place, Stanisław. DeCobray headquarters is here, and they have invested a lot of money to make it nice for their employees. For us."
Stan sighed.
"I know, Mom. It's just not Chicago," she finished.
"Yeah." They drove through the clean, well-lit, and very un-Chicago town in silence for a little while. Then his mother said,
"Why don't we drive past the school? Maybe when you see it, you will feel more excited."
"Sure, Mom, whatever you say."
"You can stop the sarcasm, my little Clash."
Clash was the nickname his father had given him when he was small, because even then he'd been a bit rowdy, and it was the name of his father's favorite rock band. He remembered that when he was really young, he and his father would dance around the apartment, blaring Rock the Casbah and Should I Stay or Should I Go, until his mother yelled at them to turn it down. His father was gone now, but his mother still used that nickname when he was being troublesome or sarcastic. And while she'd never said so, he suspected she liked using it because it reminded her of Stan's father in a tiny way that didn't hurt too much. A few blocks down, they arrived at Stan's new school. His old middle school back in Chicago hadn't been anything remarkable.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.